Minister Justin Trudeau is promising to do better. He's apologized once again for not traveling to the Tkamloops Suwetmuk First Nation last month. This is the first time Trudeau visited Kamloops since skipping events that were being held there for the first National Truth and Reconciliation Day on September 30th. The First Nation is the site of a former residential school where the remains of 215 children were found this year.
I am here today to say I wish I had been here a few weeks ago, and I deeply regret it. But I am here today to take the hands extended by the Kamloops-Tewetmuk and so many Indigenous Canadians across this country who have every reason in the world to feel pessimistic and bleak about the future and instead choose hope.
The chief of the Tkamloops Suwetmuk First Nation says two letters were sent inviting the Prime Minister on September 30th, and he had the option to pre-record a message.
The shock, anger, and sorrow and disbelief was palpable in our community, and it rippled throughout the world, to say the least. Today is about making some positive steps forward and rectifying a mistake. We wanted to ensure that Prime Minister Justin Trudeau visited what we refer to as a sacred site, the unmarked burial sites of the confirmed missing children from the Kamloops Indian Residential School.
The CEO of the Native Women's Association of Canada says now is the time for action.
There's a lot of acting sometimes going on, you know. Is this very sincere? It's very hard to have that hope that he's talking about when you're living in a genocide, when you don't have running water on your home, when your house needs a plumbing. It's easy to say, still have some hope and still believe in me. So this community had made some concrete requests today. So we're going to be looking to see and follow up if the Prime Minister is going to follow up with those concrete actions that were asked for that community.
Chief Roseanne Kastner says they will continue to advocate for complete access to student records from all residential schools in this country. Two people have been injured in a shooting in Vaughan. Police were called to the scene near Langstaff Road and Silmar Drive just after 3:30 this morning.
Officers found a vehicle with bullet holes at the scene, along with several shell casings. A second scene was found at a nearby plaza. Police say two female victims were later located
at a local hospital, suffering from gunshot injuries. Anyone who witnessed the incident or may have video surveillance of the area is asked to contact police. A violin teacher is facing nearly two dozen sexual assault charges involving a young student. 58-year-old Sue Sun, who was known as Teacher Sun to his students, taught music lessons from his home at Leslie and Shepherd. Police believe he sexually assaulted a five-year-old girl on multiple occasions. He is charged with 10 counts of sexual assault and 10 counts of sexual interference. He's set to appear in court next month. Prosecutors say the man accused of killing a woman and her two children in Ajax in 2018 was in a rage after a breakup. 33-year-old Corey Fenn has pleaded not guilty to
staff don't need to, they're not paid to do that. They're paid to take care of customers.
And it's hard enough trying to find the staff, right? Cindy, what was the situation for you? What led you to have to find security?
Well, we knew...
Public health says it supports the return to having two people at the door has been working for us.
Drug Mart, shop beauty in store and online.
Check this out.
It has been such a long time since people first started shopping online, and it was easy to keep up with the clicks. Little by little, the clicks added up to be more than the stores, and e-tailers worked harder than ever before because they had to keep up with the clicks. No time for borders. Got to stay in control, to stay in the flow and continue to grow. But we'll help you keep up with the clicks.
I look to the future, and I see what's to come. Glimpses of green grass, soft and smooth.
towering trees blowing with to and from. In the finer details, uniquely my own, I take comfort knowing this is home. Make my place by Treasure Hill. Reserve now.
Canada says vaccine passport rules are hurting many bars and kitchens struggling to make money during the pandemic. While they're scrambling to stay open and doing their best to enforce these vaccine mandates, the industry group believes the restrictions have further increased workload for staff and have hurt sales.
Restaurants Canada found that in a recent survey, more than half of restaurant operators say their employees have experienced hostile confrontation from people who oppose the new rules. The survey also found that 20% of restaurants have lost staff. More than 60% say they need to hire more workers. Joining us now to discuss all of this, Vice President of Restaurants Canada, James Rylant, along with the Executive Vice President of Imago Restaurants, Cindy Simpson, who oversees the seven British pubs in downtown Toronto, also popularly known as the Duke Pub. Okay, let's start with James. James, your group is a great aggregator of all of these restaurants and what their experiences are. So give us a sense of what they're experiencing as, you know, people get used to these new rules, and frankly, some don't like them.
What we saw, as we expected, is that most of the occurrences happened early on. Both people not knowing the rules, you had people that are just trying to make a point, and you had people that were just being obstinate. Luckily, most of the interactions were very minor, but we have to think of the staff, and unfortunately, staff don't need to. They're not paid to do that. They're paid to take care of customers.
And it's hard enough trying to find the staff, right? Cindy, what was the situation for you? What led you to have to find security?
Well, we knew pretty early on, perhaps even last year, that we needed to man our doors with extra people. And James is quite right when he says that hospitality people are very kind and they want to expect the best in everyone. And we just felt the very good double up with a security person and a hospitality person. And gave our employees a lot of support. And having two people at the door has been working for us.
Cindy, can you give us a sense of, have any of your employees experienced this kind of backlash, this kind of confrontation at the front door? And what have you had maybe an anecdote or two of what they've been experiencing over the past month since the vaccine certificates came into effect on September 22nd?
Listen, 99% of the guests are very happy. They're very happy to support us. They're very happy that we're here, and they'll do anything to help support our employees. And so this is a very small percentage of people who are behaving this way. I saw some news reports today, and we haven't seen anything like that. It looks devastating. But people are angry, and people feel disenfranchised. And sometimes they misbehave at the front door with our people or when they're seated, and it's up to us as managers to step in and stop that behavior right at the start.
But you've made the proactive choice to actually have somebody there to back up your staff. And of course, the additional staff that you had to bring in comes with its own price tag, right? How are you dealing with that on the financial front?
Well, that really is the problem, isn't it? We have to spend more money, and we do need financial support to spend more money to keep our people safe, to keep our employees safe, and frankly, to keep our customers safe. And we would love the Ford government to come out with some help for us. And I can see that this help is needed all across the province. And it's not just us that's had to spend more money, but there's lots of people that have had to spend more money or would like to spend more money, but they don't have the money.
And there's also the concerns of these businesses that have been struggling, specifically here in Ontario, James, to make money. That guest who might be upset, if they ask them to leave, they leave with their wallet, right? These restaurants need customers to stay. Is that putting more people at risk if we're having these outbursts, James?
I guess the biggest problem is if one person doesn't have their vaccination and they show up in a group of six, you have to turn the entire group away. So we've heard of issues like that, and people saying, "Well, you're not going to turn us all away if it's just one person." But the law's the law; they have to turn them away. That has caused some problems in the past, but. According to our survey, almost 60% of people report that their revenues have declined because of the vaccination passport. So that's another chink in the armor. It just shows that we're doing the heavy lifting in this instance, and that our industry needs some more support.
And so if they're against the vaccine passports in general, the QR code isn't necessarily going to make it any easier for those restaurants, I don't think. So where do we go from here? I mean, you know, the Premier has always talked about a sunset clause for these vaccine passports. Would you like a firm timeline to know when the proof of vaccination requirement is going to end and some of the benchmarks that come along with that timeline?
I don't think that's reasonable. I think we want to see the backside of this pandemic. And that's the bottom line. The last thing we want to do is get rid of the vaccine passport system just when people are getting used to it and then have to bring it back a few weeks to a month later. We had that problem back in March when they opened and then closed it straight away. That would be even worse than... Than not getting rid of it. So when we get rid of it, let's get rid of it for good.
Sydney, have you been able to receive any financial support from the government throughout this pandemic?
We have access to federal support, the wage subsidy, and rent subsidy, and we have also access to some of the supports from the Ontario government with regards to all the different supports for electricity, and there were some other supports at the beginning.
But those supports are running out. And in fact, most of them are going to be running out by this weekend. We have yet to hear what we've heard rumors that the federal government is going to continue wage and rent subsidies, but we have heard nothing. And this is very typical.
And Sydney, it's been such a tedious year for everyone in the restaurant industry, for being closed for so long, open partially, closed again. Indoor dining, patios only.
How stressed out is the entire industry
now that the vaccine certificates are adding a little bit more stress to the whole thing?
Well, you have to have a strong core to keep going, and fortunately, business people, small businesses in particular, and I think larger businesses, we do have a strong core, and we're going to stick with it.
But yes, it's very, very trying.
Well, we appreciate you making time to share your experience with us, Cindy.
James, thank you once again for joining us on CB24 tonight.
We'll continue this conversation, and we'll see where it goes. Thank you both.
Thank you.
Well, coming up on CB24 tonight, we're going to tell you about new legislation that would require temp agencies and recruiters in the province to be licensed.
That was Nasty Girl, the 90s chart topper from the former Queens of Hip Hop.
Why did they break up and where they at?
How about we get the band back together?
I'm a mom. I don't rap anymore. Well, I'm in.
Yes. It's been 20 years, and now we're going to perform at the biggest black award show. In four days, we do it our way this time.
So moms and ambitious women everywhere.
Y'all are mad corny.
Then stream anytime.
Cozy during Leon's great indoor sale. Get special prices throughout the showroom. Visit leons.ca for details.
It doesn't matter who you're taking
or where you're going. Your tires won't last forever. And now is the perfect time for new ones. Buy three tires and get the fourth free. Visit your Chrysler, Dodge, Jeep, and Ram dealer for details.
I'm Brian Baumler, and when it comes to selecting the perfect window solution, nothing compares to the DraftLock system for modern designs and quality construction.
Call today about your $5,000 rebate on all DraftLock windows.
My hygienist cleans with a round head.
So does my Oral-B.
My hygienist personalizes my cleaning.
So does my Oral-B.
Oral-B delivers the wow sensation of a professional clean feel every day.
The GTA's vaccine rollout. Where you can go. How many people have been vaccinated? And when you can get your second shot. The latest live, on air, online, and on the iHeartRadio app. On CP24.
Closed captioning of this CP24 program is brought to you by Sambucol Black Elderberry Antiviral Syrup. Helps with immune function. Available at all major retailers.
The province is introducing legislation that would require temp agencies and recruiters to be licensed. Labor Minister Monty McNaughton says there are more than 3,000 agencies in the province, and while the vast majority operate ethically, some exploit their workers. McNaughton says inspections have found that multiple agencies are paying workers below minimum wage and denying basic employment rights.
If you're not following the rules, we can and we will shut you down.
We are taking
these steps to help vulnerable workers,
mostly young people,
women, migrant workers, and newcomers
who are being exploited by unethical agencies.
My ministry is also taking immediate enforcement action.
This year, we are hiring dedicated boots on the ground to crack down on labor trafficking.
McNaughton says the government is also proposing to hire a dedicated team of officers to crack down on illegal practices and recover unpaid wages for workers.
The premier discussed the labor shortage in Ontario, but his comments are not being well received by some, saying the province needs more immigrants, but only the hard-working ones.
We need people. And so, folks, if you have some hard-working people, I just have one criteria.
You come here like every other new Canadian has come here.
You work your tail off. If you think you're coming to collect the dole and sit around, not going to happen. Go somewhere else. You want to work? Come here. We have so much work. We can't keep up with it right now.
That prompted NDP leader Andrea Horvath to tweet today that Doug Ford chose to traffic in demeaning stereotypes about Ontarians looking to build a better life for their families.
She says that he should apologize,
but we've been here before. Ms. Horvath says, sadly, this is who he is. Our diverse, welcoming province deserves better.
When we reached out to Premier Doug Ford's spokesperson about his comments today,
we received a statement that reads, quote, while the Ontario Immigrant Nominee Program is effective, it is extremely oversubscribed, which is why for the last several years we've been calling on the federal government to increase the amount of economic immigration into the province. As the Premier reiterated today, like every new Canadian who's built their life here in Ontario, our province is open to anyone and everyone who wants to work hard and support their family and contribute to their community.
Coming up tonight, do you need to start your holiday shopping a little earlier this year? The warning from retail experts about global supply chain shortages and the items expected to be in highest demand when CP24 tonight continues.
The bank is back with another $100,000 in cash.
We have so much more money to give away.
That's what I like to hear.
The bank.
Listen all day for your chance to win.
Giant 104.5.
Buy your favorite lottery tickets
from anywhere
with OLG's all-new mobile app.
See you Saturday.
Here we go, right?
get more done.
Baby skin can actually soak up wetness for diaper dozens.
That's why Pampers has Lockaway channels that lock wetness away to help keep baby skin dry and healthy. Pampers, most recommended brand by Canadian pediatricians.
The first cannonball of your vacation. Can the feeling get any better?
Use your annual round trip companion voucher with a WestJet RBC World Elite MasterCard.
Sorry, carry on.
Everyone feels better when you save up to $50
on your next trip.
I will not only buy your gold, diamonds, watches, silver, handbags, but I will sell you used Tiffany, David, and many more name brands.
Let's trade.
What is